Welcome, welcome, welcome to Goldfish on Games plays The Meaning of Life. Monty Python's The Meaning of Life. Hello! So yes, this is the game based on the film, I think you could call it. Well, so it's already installed.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. And so let's start it up. And we got fish.
Morning.
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 What's new? Not much. Morning.
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 Hey, look. How it's being eaten.
Is he?
Makes you think, doesn't it?
Hmm.
I mean, what's it all about?
What is it all about?
Why are we here?
Now let's see if YouTube's content creation copyright stuff picks this up. I have a horrible feeling it will do, and this stream will never be seen again.
We're going to
what it all out for the night is the meaning of life.
A disclaimer. The producers of this game are sensitive to the beliefs and concerns of people of all creeds, religions, and philosophical points of view. Therefore, we deem it essential to alert anyone who may belong to one or more of the following groups that the material contained herein is particularly disgusting. Please read carefully.
Sorry about that, just had to change up the volume slightly. If you saw the cabling make these streams work, you would go insane. And look at this disclaimer. Please read carefully. Catholics, Presbyterians, Christian Scientists, Mormons, sticklers for detail, men with huge breasts, fascists, druids, Baptists, glue sniffers, technocrats, dualists, romantics, liars, conservatives. They could have just kept those two together. Who else? We got turtles. Oh, don't want to insult the turtles. Spinners, tossers, drunkards, dizzy people, chauvinists, Thatcherites, or getting all political here, goats, chickens, and fictional characters.
Please choose one of these options.
I don't understand any of this.
Ah, I bet you're wondering what this game is about.
I do.
Looks like we're in the same boat, so to speak. What is the meaning of life, anyway?
That's what I'm here to find out.
My friend, and maybe we'll all find out.
And this is our main menu. I have played this very briefly just to get an understanding of the controls. But, you can click on him.
Go ahead, flush me. Won't bother me a bit. I'm a professional. You see, when you've been a symbolic representation of man for as long as I have, you get used to little things like being sprawled out in the nude and gawked at by strangers, and then flushed down the drain for fun. Comes with the territory, so go ahead, gawk a bit, giggle if you want, then give me a flush or two, I can take it.
So you can select the various different phases of life, and then when you pick one, you can then flush him, which takes you to the section. So, let's flush him at birth. And if any of you have seen the film,
The Miracle of Birth.
Lots of this.
More contractions are more frequent, Doctor.
Go on, take her into the fetus frightening room.
Right.
A lot of this should be very recognisable.
Sir, it's barren in there, isn't it? Yes. Yes, more apparatus, please, nurse.
Yes, and so it acts a bit like a point-and-click adventure. You can sort of look around. As we can see, it's pretty bare. But we can click on the nurse and
the EEG, the BP monitor, and the AVV.
Yes, certainly, Doctor.
And get the machine that goes beep, and get the most expensive machine in case the administrator comes.
dink, dink, donk, dink, plonk.
That's better, that's much, much better. Yes, more like it.
Yes.
Still something missing, though. Patient!
And now we've got to try and find the patient.
Where's the patient? Anyone seems like patient?
Oh, there's our patient.
Here she is.
Bring it over here.
Mind the machine!
Sorry, Dr. Spence.
Come along!
Hello, you're here as well. You're here as long as well as the patient. Let's get her out.
Oh no, now don't you worry.
We'll soon have you cured.
Leave it all to us, you'll never know what hit you.
The administrator is here, Doctor.
Switch everything on.
And now we have to turn everything on. Click. Gotta find the machine that goes ping. Oh, there we go, there's another machine. That's another one. Squeaky, squeaky. Squeaky, squeaky. Oh, the light's back there. Who do you have to click on next? Do you have to keep going around trying to find everything? It's a point-and-click adventure. Oh, there we go.
Morning, gentlemen.
Morning.
Morning, Mr. Pycroft. Oh, very impressive. Very impressive. And what are you doing this morning?
It's a birth. Ah, what sort of thing is that?
Well, that's when we take a new baby out of a lady's tummy.
Wonderful what you can do nowadays. Ah, I see you have the machine that goes bing. This is my favorite. You see, we lease this back from the company we sold it to, and that way it comes under the monthly current budget and not the capital account. Thank you. We try to do our best. Well, do carry on.
I've actually worked at places that done that.
What's that for?
That's the machine that goes bing.
You see, that means your baby is still alive.
Though she might not be, because how the hell is lying down and turned her head round like that? That seems impossible.
Can I put the tube in the baby's head?
Only if I can do the episiotomy.
Okay.
There you go.
Okay.
What do I do?
Yes?
What do I do?
Nothing, dear. You're not qualified.
Leave it to us.
Is anyone qualified?
Oh, the vulva's dilating, Doctor.
Oh, yes, there's the head. Yes, 4 centimetres, 5, 6 centimetres.
Light!
Amplify the ping machine.
Faster!
Suction!
Eyes down for fluff!
Bing!
Here it comes!
Bonk! And we... Oh, we actually get to pick something up. It's almost like it's a actual point and click adventure.
Oh, one penny.
I think she's got quite a few inside. Watch, doing, doing. This seems like the setup for the third world gag.
Here it comes! Eyes down for full house!
And at this point, I think we're now done in this area. At least as far as I understand it. We found an item, we've done everything we can here. Well, apart from firing more babies out. And so we can now go back to the main menu. And move on to the next section. And I think what you're meant to do is try and find stuff in the various bits that'll help you solve puzzles in the other areas. Maybe. The guy, the manual for this actually says, hey, we're not going to tell you how to play. So, there we go.
Well, it's not much of a job, I admit. But I've got the wife and kids at home, and someone's got to keep them fed, haven't they?
So let's flush him again.
The Meaning of Life, Part 2. Growth and Learning.
And spotteth twice they the camels before the third hour. And so the Midianites went forth to Ram Gilead in Kadesh Bilgameth, by Shore Ethba Regalion to the house of Gashbil Bethuel Bazda, he who brought the butter dish to Belshazzar and the tent peg to the house of Rashomon. And there slew they the goats, yea, and placed they the bits in little pots. Here endeth the lesson.
Oh, look at all those kids. Donuts. Oh, well, I'm not sure if I'm actually allowed to show that on YouTube. I might have to change this and make it mature only. YouTube might kill me. An excellent traditional school with an excellent tradition of traditionally excellent tradition. Oh, that seems very Monty Python. Yes, let's just... It was a bum with a pimple. If anyone asks. Oh, there we go. So yeah, you can zoom in and out of various sections. Whoops. Oh, this might get me absolutely cream crackered. Can I, let's see if my stream options, if I can set things to be mature only. Am I allowed to... there we go. I've set it to mature... for mature audiences only, I think. Or age restriction... enable age restrictions. Fingers crossed that I'm not going to get absolutely cream-crackered for this. And yeah, see, oh dear. I probably should have expected that. Or expected similar things. And oh, am I losing people because I've enabled age restrictions? I'm sorry, it has to be done, because honestly, I played that beginning bit in the birthing room. And I was like, yes, I have to play this on stream. And I didn't really realise that, this is going to have nudity in it. I probably should have guessed by the box. It just said mature themes. That could have been anything. Let's continue looking around.
This is a baptismal font. It is full of holy water.
Piss. So, let's see.
Chaplain?
I hope this video is just going to be just me sort of giggling to myself at the stupid jokes. Though it might be.
Let us praise God. O Lord.
O Lord.
Ooh, you are so big.
Ooh, you are so big.
So absolutely huge.
Oh, so absolutely huge.
Gosh, we're all really impressed down here, I can tell you.
Gosh, we're really impressed down here, I can tell you.
Forgive us, O Lord, for this our dreadful toadying. But you're so strong and, well, just so super.
I do wish you'd pay attention, otherwise there's no point in doing this at all, is there?
There, I've finished.
Okay.
Weep. Now, two boys have been found rubbing linseed oil into the school cormorant. Now, some of you may feel that the cormorant does not play an important part in the life of the school, but I would remind you that it was presented to us by the corporation of the town of Sudbury to commemorate Empire Day, when we try to remember the names of all those from the Sudbury area who so gallantly gave their lives to keep China British. So from now on, the cormorant is strictly out of bounds.
Out of bounds.
Oh, and Jenkins?
Yes?
Apparently your mother died this morning.
Oh, no. And he flies off again.
I do wish you'd pay attention, otherwise there's no point in doing this at all, is there?
Is that all he does now? I think it might be.
I do wish you'd pay attention, otherwise there's no point in doing this at all, is there?
Is that? Is there anything else we can interact with? Okay. No!
All right. Who did that?
Why? You can tell the Monty Python team had something to do with this. Oh, we can go in there. Is that available before? Ooh. You've finally embarked on a long-awaited automobile trip to visit the world-famous Synthetic Fabrics Manufacturer Hall of Fame. You've picked the host of nutritious snacks. You've marked your route with bright orange marker on a big highway map you need to keep unfolded on your lap for easy access. Your flashlight is located with loaded with brand new batteries, just in case, then disaster strikes. Your worst fear comes true as you realize your car is full of visiting relatives, frightening hallucination, cockroaches, or wee-wee. I think frightening hallucinations. Ah, it's this scene. And this might get dirty again.
Oh, I got a triple fracture of the right leg, dislocated collarbone, and multiple head injuries.
A car full of wee-wee would have been a problem. Thankfully, you can open the door and it would have just flowed out. But, hallucinations? Ooh.
Oh,
So I guess he comes over there and... they come from over there. That's good to know. Oh, where... I was expecting the teacher to be here somewhere. Oh, there we go. Ah, now that's when you're meant to scratch there. Yeah, you just sort of crank the heaters in the car up and eventually the damp will go away and the smell might linger for a bit, but... it'll go after a while.
Now, before I begin the lesson, will those of you who are playing in the match this afternoon move your clothes down onto the lower peg immediately after lunch? Before you write your letter home, if you're not getting your hair cut, unless you've got a younger brother who's going out this weekend as the guest of another boy, in which case collect his note before lunch, put it in your letter after you've had your hair cut, and make sure he moves your clothes down onto the lower peg for you. Sir?
Supposedly this was actually based on...
Sir?
Some actual history from...
Sir?
Him.
Sir? My younger brother's going out with Dibble this weekend, sir, but I'm not having my hair cut today, sir, so do I move my clothes down?
You should listen, Weimer. It's perfectly simple. If you're not getting your hair cut, you don't have to move your brother's clothes down to the lower peg. You simply collect his note before lunch, after you've done your scripture prep, when you've written your letter home before rest, move your own clothes onto the lower peg, greet the visitors, and report to Mr. Viney that you've had your chit signed.
Yeah, supposedly that was based on one of his old headmasters.
Now, sex.
Yes.
Sex. Where were we? Did I or did I not do vaginal juices?
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Name two ways of getting them flowing.
I don't know, sir. I don't know.
Striking the thigh, sir.
Yes, good. Nibbling the earlobe, kneading the buttocks, and so on and so forth.
Biting the neck?
Yes.
Rubbing the clitoris, sir?
What's wrong with a kiss boy?
Interesting, he's got a different symbol. I wonder if these ones you can actually use some of the...
Rubbing the clitoris, sir?
What's wrong with a kiss boy?
Suck the nipple, sir.
Now, all these forms of stimulation can now take place. Start her off with a nice kiss. You don't have to go leaping straight for the clitoris like a bullet again. Give her a kiss, boy.
I wasn't expecting that. I truly wasn't. I will apologize for anyone who might try and watch this at work or in public.
Could you kindly wake up? I have no intention of going through this all again.
What?
What's funny, Biggs?
Oh, nothing, sir.
Oh, do please share your little joke with the rest of us. I mean, obviously, something frightfully funny is going on.
No, honestly, sir.
Well, as it's so funny, I think you better be selected to play for the boys' team in the rugby match against the Masters this afternoon.
Oh, no, sir.
Oh, I got a triple fracture of the right leg. Dislocated collarbone. and multiple head injuries.
Ooh. What? Suppose, just suppose. Your daughter is heading off to college. You are concerned about her because she is stupid. So you sit her down and give her one important piece of advice. Bridget, you say, before you go off to college, I feel you should make sure you know how to put on your clothing, keep yourself smelling fresh, speak to others without striking them, keep your extremities out of big hot fires. So, what do we think? It's like, putting on your clothing? Probably quite important. Keeping yourself smelling fresh? Well, I've been to a few conventions. I know that's not always that important to some people. Speak to others without striking them? Probably quite useful. But some people just need to be hit. And keep your extremities out of big hot fires. Probably a good idea, I think.
Hello, my name is Kenneth. My name is Kenneth. Hello there. I'm Kenneth. Hi, I'm Kenneth. Hello, everybody. My name is Hello, my name is Ken. Hello? My name is Kenneth. Hello, everyone. Good evening. My name is... Hello.
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 My name is Kenneth Van der Blup. Hello and welcome to You Don't Know John, the program where modern erudition and historical knowledge clash within a competitive context. My name is Kenneth Van der Burlap, and I shall be your host. Very well, let's explain the rules of the game, shall we? There are 7 questions per game. You have a limited amount of time, so be sure to select your answer just as soon as you can. All right? Everybody ready?
Okay. I have no idea what's going on.
Question number 1.
The other category.
The name of this category is the other category. A correct answer will be worth £5.
Ooh.
And here is your question. Who would be the most likely superhero in a world full of supermen? 1. Wonder Poodle. 2. Ultra Waiter. 3. The Radioactive Tobacconist. 4. Bicycle Repairman.
Well, it has to be the Ultra Waiter, obviously.
Yes, you've answered wrongly.
Ah.
Question number 2.
Gotta be the history of the naughty bits.
The name of this category is the history of naughty bits. A correct answer will be worth £10.
Ooh, a whole £10.
And here is your question. In the good old days, plants survived by roaming the earth, shooting each other with bolts of electricity, then ripping each other apart with massive, jagged teeth. Nowadays, plants survive using the relatively boring process known as 1. Walking the streets, 2. Dealing drugs, 3. Liquor store holdups, 4. Photosynthesis.
Now, I know what the actual answer is, but is that the answer we want to go with? Should we actually try and get our score above minus £5? I don't want to owe the game money. Let's try going with the real answer, see what happens.
Photosynthesis is correct. Although plants actually do all those other things, they don't really need to survive.
It's good to remember.
Question number 3.
Air Force grannies. Deadly nomadic tongue twisters of the Kalahari. And oh my god, that corpse just moved.
We are waiting for you to choose a category.
Has to be, oh my god, that corpse just moved.
The name of this category is My God, That Corpse Just Moved. A correct answer will be worth £15. And here is your question. If you were in a stall in a public toilet and the fellow on your lap said, "We shall fight them on the beaches, we shall fight them on the landing ground, we shall fight them in the fields and in the streets, we shall fight them in the hills, we shall never surrender," then who, on this particular day, would most likely be on your lap? 1. Kim Il-sung. 2. Ho Chi Minh. 3. Winston Churchill. 4. I'm afraid that's all the time we can give you. Sorry, let's proceed. Question number 4.
Classified nuclear secrets.
The name of this category is classified nuclear secrets. A correct answer will be worth £25.
Ooh,
and
big
here
money.
Is your question. But I have sinuous shells of pearly hue. Shake one and it awakens. Then apply its polished lips to your attentive ear, and it remembers its august abodes and murmurs, 1. Oh shit, I left the rolls in the oven. 2. As the ocean murmurs there. 3. Hey, I can see your cerebral cortex. 4. Penny for your thoughts, you big dung heap.
Has to be as the ocean murmurs there.
This is not the right answer. You should not have selected this one.
Oh.
Question number
I'm like minus £20. Not this category.
The name of this category is not this category. A correct answer will be worth £50.
Ooh, might be able to make my money back.
And here is your question. I am asking this question, 1, to fool you, 2, to make you feel foolish, 3, to make you look like a fool, 4, because you are so very, very smart.
What do you think, chat? What do you think the answer is? Because I think they're trying to make me feel foolish. Oh, can we actually leave? Don't want to leave just yet. Spot! Okay. Oh. All of the above except 4. And so far it's like, anything but 4.
I am sorry, but time is up. Sorry. Oh. Too bad. That was just fascinating. Moving right along. Question number 6.
I didn't answer it in time. Trees that would die on.
The name of this category is trees that would die on Mars. A correct answer will be worth £100.
Ooh.
And here is your question. According to Friedrich Engels in the Communist Manifesto, the theory of the communists may be summed up in the single phrase, 1, I sure hope I get lucky, 2, look at the jugs on that one, 3, the only thing better than a glass of cold whiskey in my hand is a hot woman in my lap, 4, abolition of private property. Oh, and also zesty teasy whiz wham tingle dingle dum. Oh, sorry, the correct answer is 5. None of the above. Well, now it's time for Final John, the last round of our competition, so I shall explain the rules. If you have two words to form a match, then by pressing right. That's all there is to it.
Oh,
now,
good.
Please select a category.
Oh, gotta select another category. Amputee time.
The category you have chosen is amputee time. So you can be relatively sure that your matches will have nothing to do with that. Every time you are right, you will be awarded money. However, every time you are wrong, money will be taken away. Please remember the words moving from side to side will not be considered a match unless they fit the clue, which descends slowly from the top to the bottom of your screen. Now, assuming these rules are understood, let's begin with Final John.
Nope. Spelling. Oh, of course. Why didn't you go and your bed full of queens? Why don't you go and sit on a 12-inch road? Oh, no. Blow it out, yo. Yay! I think you have to keep making mistakes. Why are you sniveling, little? Oh, no, there we go. Why didn't you do a favour and swinging both ways? Nope. Guess this exchange. Okay. I'm sick and tired of. Hey, we might actually be making some money here. Just not fish and chips.
Very impressive. Well, that's the end of our competition. I hope you enjoyed it as thoroughly as I did. Unfortunately, as you can see, you haven't quite yet made it into the pantheon of terribly smart people.
Yep.
Play again now or play again later. Just play and keep on playing. You'll get into the pantheon eventually. And when you do, you'll find you'll have stronger teeth, a shinier coat, and something else that's very important that I'm not going to tell you about.
Oh, please don't tell me I have to actually get something from that mini-game. Ah, well, answer to be mocked. Yet another weird question. Of the following, would you rather have a room full of drooling spectators while watching a technician massage your legs, lick your underarms, shave your head, or oil your chest? Well, I don't think anyone wants to watch my chest getting oiled. That would be a bit weird. Shaving my head, well, it's mostly already gone already, so that seems like the best option. Oh, and we're back here again. Oh no. No, I don't want to do that.
Hello, my name is Kenneth. My name... Hello and...
So I wonder if that's all you get to do in this section. Because... That leads us back to here. Can we go anywhere else here? Or do we need to complete that puzzle? Or the questions to be able to move on? But I say we try saving. And for now, let's try one of the other eras. So, fighting each other.
The Meaning of Life, Part 3, Fighting Each Other.
I'm just assuming you just have to shoot everything that shows up. And then you just close it. Okay. Ah! And that dirtied up the screen. I have to clean it off. Understand the meaning of life available on video cassette. I don't think it is anymore. Anyway, I think we've got a... Yep.
Today we're going to do marching up and down the square! That is, unless any of you got anything better to do! Well, anyone got anything they'd rather be doing than marching up and down the square?
I'd rather be playing games.
Atkinson, what would you rather be doing, Atkinson?
Well, to be quite honest, Sarge, I'd rather be at home with the wife and kids.
Would you now?
Yes, Sarge.
Right, off you go!
Are we just going to go through all of them?
Now, everybody else happy with my little plan? Of yep. Marching up and down the square a bit?
Sarge?
Yes?
I've got a book I'd quite like to read.
Right, you go read your book then.
Sounds like a great Sarge to me.
Now, everybody else quite content to join in with my little scheme of marching up and down the square?
Sarge?
Yes, Wycliffe, what is it?
Well, I'm learning the piano.
Learning the piano?
Yes, Sarge.
And I suppose you want to go and practice, eh? Marching up and down the square, not good enough for you, eh?
Well...
Right, off you go!
Learning the piano is very important.
Now, what about the rest of you? Rather be at the pictures, I suppose. All right, off you go! Bloody army, I don't know where it's coming to. Right, Sergeant Major marching up and down the square. Left, right, left, right,
left, right.
Oh, that's much better. Thank you, honey.
You're welcome.
This game is just pure filth. Oh, you can go over the hill.
So, if we don't meet again, sir, I'd just like to say it's been a real privilege fighting alongside you, sir.
Yes, well, this is the time or place for goodbye speech, eh?
No, me and the lads realise that, sir, but, well, we may never meet again, sir, so...
Yes, all right, Blackett, thanks a lot.
No, just a moment, sir. See, me and the lads, we've had a little whip around, sir. We brought you something, sir. We brought you this, sir.
The clock.
Well, I don't know what to say. It's a lovely thought.
Thank you.
Well, thank you all. But I think we better get to the terminal.
I was wondering how long that scene was actually going to play.
Well, of course, warfare isn't all fun. It's all very well to laugh at the military, but when one considers the meaning of life, it is a struggle between alternative viewpoints of life itself.
What was that? What was that? Hey?
He mentioned the meaning of life.
And without the ability to defend one's own viewpoint against other, perhaps more aggressive ideologies, then reasonableness and moderation could quite simply disappear. That is why we'll always need an army. And may God strike me down were it to be otherwise. May God strike me down were it to be otherwise. May God strike me down were it to be otherwise.
Okay, so obviously I need something that I can use here to strike him down. Which we probably get from the previous bit. Oh! That wasn't what I was expecting.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's truly a real honorable experience to be here this evening. A very wonderful and warm and emotional moment for all of us.
I can't hear that scream without thinking of Command and Conquer. Oh, God.
Oh, fishy, 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 fish.
It is the most elusive fish. Oh, fishy, fishy, fishy fish.
And he went wherever fishy, that fish, fishy, fish did go.
Oh, fishy, fishy, fishy.
And he went wherever that fish did go. Oh, so says the Cleesus, the Captain Burn Messiah. You find a stranger lying on the sidewalk in a cold winter's night. He has clearly drunk himself unconscious. Hoping to teach the fellow a kind lesson, you steal his credit card and treat yourself to a wild night on the town. Then, to further encourage him to keep better track of his finances, you helpfully use his own money to have him hauled off the sidewalk and thrown into a room at a 5-star luxury hotel, a cold but comfortable tidy little shack, a warm but filthy cheap bathhouse, a warm and tidy moderately priced donkey brothel. Well, it's got to be the donkey brothel. Where else are you going to send him? This game, that film.
Ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
We showed him, didn't we, sir?
Yes.
Sorry about the mess.
Morning, sir.
Nasty wound you got there, Potter.
Thank you very much, sir.
Better than staying at home, isn't it, sir? Eh? I mean, at home, if you kill someone, they arrest you. Here, they give you a gun and show you what to do, sir. I mean, I'll kill 15 of those buggers, sir. Now, at home, they'd hang me. Here, they'll give me a fucking medal, sir.
What is out of the time for that, is it, Sergeant?
Excuse me, sir. I'm afraid Perkins got rather badly bitten during the night.
He did get badly bitten.
Ah, morning, Perkins.
Sir.
What's all the trouble then?
Bitten, sir, during the night.
Whole leg gone, eh?
Yes.
We congratulate our dauntless officer corps as they battle gallantly to keep Africa British. Furthermore, we advise all the painted-faced troublemakers, put down your spears and go elsewhere.
Thank you very much.
You must have a hell of a hole in your net.
Yes, good lord, look at this.
That is a hell of a hole in your net.
Any idea how it happened? None whatsoever. Complete mystery to me. Woke up just now. One sock too many.
What?
Well, we sent for the doctor. Morning.
Morning.
Real beauty, isn't it?
I came as fast as I could. Is something up?
Yes, sir. During the night, old Perkins got his leg bitten sort of off.
Been in the wars, have we?
Yes.
Well, let's have a look at this one leg of yours, then, eh?
Oh, good.
Yes. Well, this is nothing to worry about. Probably a virus.
Well-known viruses that remove legs.
Yeah, there's a lot of it about.
Real beauty, isn't it?
By Jove! That's enormous!
You don't think it'll come back, do you?
That's what she said.
By Jove! That's enormous!
You don't think it'll come back, do you?
Keep warm, plenty of rest.
Might say a macrovirus if you were a Voyager fan.
It's right as rain in a couple of days. Oh, good.
No, that's not warm.
Excuse me, sir.
Does it continue from where it was? Oh, it's...
If you're playing football or anything, try and
favour the other leg. Yes, there's a lot of it about.
Oh, righto. Thanks for the reassurance, Doc. So it'll just grow back again then, will it?
I think I'd better come clean with you about this. It's not a virus, I'm afraid. You see, a virus is what we doctors call very, very small. So small it could not possibly have made off with a whole leg. What we're looking for here is, I think, and this is no more than an educated guess, I'd like to make that clear, is some multicellular life form with stripes, huge, razor-sharp teeth, about 11 foot long, and of the genus Felis horribilis. What we doctors, in fact, call a tiger.
A tiger?
How would you want to forget about the macrovirus from Voyager? You had Action Janeway running around with the phaser rifle and everything. That was cool. Almost as cool as this.
Woke up just now? One sock too many.
One sock too many.
Any headache? Bowels all right? Jolly good.
Sir! The attack's over, sir.
Oh, jolly good.
Quite a lot of casualties there, sir.
Yes, well, the thing is, Sergeant, I've got a bit of a problem here. One of the officers has lost a leg. The MO says we can stitch it back on if we can find it immediately.
Right, sir. Oh, I'll organise a party right away, sir.
Well, it's hardly the time for that, is it, Sergeant?
A search party.
Oh, much better idea.
Search party.
Right.
Oh, hardly worth it, is it? Oh, yes, better safe than sorry.
I've still only got one item in our inventory, which is a penny. And I don't think the penny is going to be useful here.
Zippy, 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 no.
I guess I was right. That's not the thing we're going to use here. So.
Morning, Ainsworth.
Morning, Tuckerham. Sleep well?
Not bad.
Bit to shreds, though. Must be a hole in the bloody mosquito nest.
Yeah, savage little blighters, aren't they?
Oh, Sally, I can't think of a better time to ask for this. Will you marry me?
Oh, Cedric, you've made me the happiest girl in the world!
That was weird.
This is fancy, isn't it? Always killing, bloodshed.
Very good fancy, isn't it?
Oh, I feel dizzy.
Okay, wasn't expecting that.
Ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
So I think we need to go back and play more. Let's continue on a bit. I'm not sure if those bits actually mean much. So yeah. So we keep going on until we see if we can get more items before we have to start going back and playing over some of the bits we've already done. I don't know if this is a great idea or not.
Middle age.
Good evening. Would you care for something to talk about?
What the...
You make me dizzy, Daisy D.
Dizzy, dizzy, Daisy D.
You say the things I long to hear.
All the things I want to hear. You're the sunlight in my eyes, and my love I can't deny. skies. Every moment that you're near, that you're near.
Okay. And are these going to do the same? Very good. Very good. Oh, keep going around and we're background to here. So.
Oh, that would be wonderful.
Hello, I'm Diane. I'm your waitress for tonight.
Okay, I wasn't expecting that. I was going to say something else a second ago, but oh God. Oh, okay.
Okay, fine. Thank you, sir.
These are the Henders. They are trying to have a conversation. The problem? They have nothing to talk about. Your job? Choose a topic from the menu. Then you decide what Mr. Hendy says. Mrs. Hendy will do the rest. If you're smart, you'll figure out how to finish the conversation. If you're not smart, well, good luck. Because with the Hendys, you'll need all the luck you can get.
Have a nice conversation!
Okay. Okay. I'm so glad I enabled mature for audiences for this video. Oh, this is not going to end well for me at all.
Sex is nice, and I think sex is cute. When we're having sex, it's a real swell time.
You said it?
You said it! I like to talk about sex because it gives me a super happy feeling inside. And now I'm finished. What should we talk about now?
Our endangered ocean...
Otters are nice. And I think otters are cute. They're real lovable creatures. Baby seals are almost as lovable as otters are.
Yeah.
Are otters a kind of fish? They live in the water, but I'm pretty sure they're not a kind of fish. Fish taste fishy. I bet otters don't.
I don't like this conversation anymore. Let's start again.
Okay, so that gives me an idea that you can select something wrong. I wonder how otters sound.
I wonder how otters sound. Monkeys sure sound funny. I wish otters made noises like monkeys, because that would make me laugh.
Oh, don't like that either.
I don't like this conversation anymore. Let's start again.
Let's just say otters are nice, and otters are cute.
Otters are nice, and I think otters are cute. Otters are all sorts of colors, too. Lunchboxes have plenty of colors. I once saw a lunchbox that was purple.
This conversation is great. We should keep having this conversation because this conversation has been really super interesting.
Okay. Oh, Lord. If we keep talking about the same thing, it will be swell. What are we talking about makes me think of lemons. Let's keep having our conversation just like you say. This conversation is great.
This conversation is great. You said it. Say, does the circus start with F? I like the circus.
We went to the circus once. Our seats were pretty good because they were right in front of the clowns. The clowns were real funny.
I have no answer to that. I like the acrobats because the acrobats were super. We went to the circus once. The clowns were great. Baby elephants walled in circles with the... walled? Is that meant to be walked in circles? Now let's just go with the clowns are great.
The clowns were great. They made me laugh so that I forgot all my troubles.
Oh, how...
I don't like this conversation anymore. Let's start again.
Let's keep... has this gone back one?
This conversation is great. You said it. Say, does the circus start with F? I like the circus.
Okay, so it takes you back one.
The circus once? Our seats were pretty good because they were...
So you have to... It takes you back one, so you have to try and remember what your previous answer was. I think it's just we went to the circus once, I bet.
We went to the circus once? You're right. We sat where the red seats were. There were lots of funny lions. Lions eat people, but they don't eat peanuts.
I like peanut butter. You can buy some that's smooth, or you can get it chunky. And you can mix it with lots of different things to make a real good sandwich.
So I'm gonna guess peanut butter has lots of textures.
Peanut butter has a lot of textures. Textures remind me of Texas.
Nope. I think it's the last one.
I don't like this conversation anymore. Let's start again.
We went to the circus once.
We went.
And I think it's I like peanut butter. I'm gonna bet.
I like peanut butter, just like you do. I wonder who invented peanut butter. There sure must be a lot of good inventors.
Oh, there must be plenty of them. Somebody invented the telephone. And somebody invented lasers. And somebody else invented PJs. I think there are lasers inside some telephones, and I know you can talk on the telephone in your PJs, but I don't think you can buy PJs with lasers inside.
I think you should best get PJs with lasers inside. So, anyone guess what this should be? Oh, there must be plenty of them. I like lasers, because lasers kill aliens from outer space. When you say PJs, I think you mean pajamas, and PJs are real super useful. I think it's PJs are really super useful.
PJs are real super useful. Snow plows are useful.
Really?
I don't like...
I like peanut butter. Must be plenty of them?
Oh, there must be plenty of them. Inventors, I mean. Not PJs with lasers inside. After all, somebody invented rocket ships. I wonder if rocket ships have sofas. I sort of wish I hadn't said sofas. Sofas remind me of your Aunt Sophie. She was real fat and lazy, and she left big greasy sweat stains on our upholstery.
Aunt Sophie was my favorite aunt.
hay.
Okay, so we got some hay. I have absolutely no idea that's useful for. I can't think of any situation we've seen so far that we could use hay in. Let's see if there's any other sections to... Oh, this horse, hey. And...
Cows. I love cows.
What
they make cheese. I think cheese tastes super with apple
some
pie.
Hay.
Don't you?
Wait, but what? I like cheese.
I like cheese. It's nifty. Cheese tastes almost as good as peanut butter. Only peanut butter is light brown.
Now, don't distract me. What did I just say?
Meows or meows. That was the name of my cat. He was a pie-eating cat. He ate pies all the time.
Wait, what?
Pies, say pies. Wow, that's swell. I once saw a movie about a cat who fell off a surfboard and swam to Hawaii.
What? I guess that one, maybe?
Don Ho lives in Hawaii. They have lots of taxis. Don Ho rides in taxis all the time.
This doesn't seem like a good conversation anymore. What was I saying before?
Meow meows. I think we should go to Hawaii and look at the volcanoes.
I think we should go to Hawaii and look at the volcanoes. Volcanoes have coconuts. But hot lava can really burn you up.
Boom.
Now.
Waikiki sounds silly to me.
Waikiki sounds pretty silly to me. So does uvula. Uvula's a super funny word.
Okay. I managed to pick the wrong answer. So what was it? Thighs.
Thighs, hey, thighs. Hawaiians have real strong thighs. And they love word games. Say, let's play a word game. That would be great fun.
I have...
Oodles and oodles. I'll go first. I'm thinking of a word that begins with K. It's a marsupial.
Kangaroo.
I'm thinking of a famous singer whose first name is Tom. And his last name is Jones. Oh, I think I just gave my answer away.
This doesn't seem like a...
Marsupials are a kind of animal. They're real handy to have around the house because they can use pliers.
What?
They can fix things.
I get the feeling...
Thighs. Hey...
Letter J sounds like the letter K.
The letter J sounds like the letter K. But I don't think that J is a marsupial. So it must be something besides J. Maybe L.
Nope. So, poodles and poodles.
Poodles and poodles. Hey, that game was a really good time. What now?
What? How would that be answer?
I think a great thing would be to reminisce about our fantastic courtship.
Dear Lord, how long does this go on for? I remember lots about that.
I remember lots about that. It was funny. I laughed a lot. A whole bunch. Because it was funny. Poor... On our first date, we had ham. It was tasty. Ham contains nitrates. That's a preservative. I read about that in Reader's Digest.
Obviously, that was the answer.
You smarty, smarty. You're smarter than smart. I know. We could talk about how smart you are. Because you're real smart.
Yep, he really is. That has to be the answer, right?
I'm not as smart as you are, Honey Bunch. You add numbers together in your head. Adding numbers is useful.
But how's that?
This does.
Oh, farty. Oh,
farty, farty. Boy, that creeped up on me super unexpected. My face sure is red. Remember your mother? Her face was all red and blotchy. Just looking at her made me sick. And she smelled pretty bad, too. Wow, what a big, smelly, blotchy faced pig she was.
Marvin!
Rats!
Obviously.
Some strangers say super startling surprises are scary. That big rat falling from nowhere sure was a surprise. I love surprises, don't you?
I have no idea what's going on. Surprises are nifty.
Surprises are nifty. Except for poisonous snakes. I would classify poisonous snakes as not nifty at all.
You know, I think rats aren't reptiles.
You know, I think that rats aren't reptiles. I'm pretty sure that rats are something else. Rats like to nibble, and nibble all day long.
I like birthday cakes?
Sure, super surprises sometimes seem swell. But that surprise was too scary. I like surprises that are warm and fuzzy. Sweaters are a nice surprise.
Sweaters are super swell. September to springtime. You've got lots of sweaters. Some are cardigan. Some are pullover, some are acrylic, and some are wool.
Of course. Wool comes from sheep?
Wool comes from sheep. Sheep are fluffy and funny. They make super noises when you listen.
Sorry, there's meat at
the
desk.
This doesn't seem like a good company.
Sure.
I have some jackets.
I have some jackets. Some of my jackets have buttons, and some of them have zippers. Zippers are great.
Obviously.
Sure.
I think acrylic is a brush.
I don't think acrylic is a bush. I've never heard of an acrylic farmer. That's a real big mystery to me.
Of course.
Sure.
So what was it? Some seem super small.
Some seem small on my super stretchy stomach. Say, speaking of surprises, how about the time you got the gout? That wasn't a sweater, but it sure was a surprise.
Great gargantuan goiters are goofier than gout. They're funny. I sat next to a person with a goiter on an airplane once. And I told him it was swell. Remember?
Swell and silly.
Swell and silly. You were sick with air sickness and it made you funny. You did some real silly stuff.
Of course. We were flying to Miami.
We were flying to Miami. Miami has lots of sun and some nice tall palm trees.
For anyone who likes lots of sun and nice tall palm trees, I would definitely recommend Miami. Goiters really are super funny, all right. I sometimes wonder what it would be like to have one in a big jar of formaldehyde right on our living room table.
I'm not doing too well at this point. I seem to be picking the wrong one.
Gosh, goiters are gushy and gross. I don't think I like them very much. Although they're not as bad as the time I ran over Mr. Yippee, our pet chihuahua. He died, and that made me sad.
He's having hugs in heaven, so let's think happy thoughts. Sometimes, if you're real lucky, a super happy thought will just sneak up and surprise you, like a really great commercial on TV.
You cheered me up, honey lamb. You sure know how to make me happy. Being happy is good. Maybe we could talk about how great it is to be happy. Goiter.
Oh no, I made a mistake there.
Some.
No, I don't want to go backwards.
Gosh.
Let's pick the stupidest answer.
Hilarious, hilarious humor. Your funny words sneak up on me, Lamb Chop, and they make me happy. I'm really glad we're having this conversation.
Obviously.
Conversations can cause confusion or constructiveness. I'm glad our conversation is going so super great. I wonder if it's supposed to keep going.
I have a feeling this conversation will never end, that's for sure.
I've got a super good feeling that this conversation will never end. You chip.
Oh no.
God.
What was that one? I think we should keep talking forever.
I think we should keep talking forever.
How about if we stop talking now? Yes, that would be great.
How about if we stop talking now? I thought stopping would be swell, but I'm not sure. What do you think?
Obviously. Which one didn't I pick? Can't completely conclude this conversation.
Can't completely conclude this conversation? Because I have more things to say. Like, I'm struck by a funny memory of your father. He had way too much hair growing out of his armpits. And his nose was full of creepy mucus.
He was my daddy.
Damn!
Hey. What? Of course, a dam. What are we gonna do with this dam? Turn off the power, it seems. We'll start the power up, and we've got...
Ooh, a sprig of dill!
Obviously.
I'm all talked out. Let's eat.
Oh, Marvin, I think that's a super great idea.
Oh! Okay. This starts to make a bit more sense. So I got a coin from there. But that wasn't the end of it. It'll give you a symbol. Yeah. Oh. I wonder if it's all self-contained.
Eyes down for Flouse! Here it comes!
So, was there more we could do in here then? Because I don't remember. There's that thing. There's that machine. I don't think we can do anything more with that. Okay, so what have we got there? We can't... That sprig, we can't use anything more. Yes, this is very surreal, isn't it? I have no idea what the hell is going on or what I'm going to be doing. It's... So I can click on them. Oh, there we go.
The Miracle of Birth, Part 2. The Third World.
There we go. Donk.
Oh, get that, would you, Deirdre?
That one.
Oh, bloody hell.
Here we go, we're in the Third World. Or as the film called it, Yorkshire.
Has anyone seen my lamb?
Here it is, dear.
Oh,
bloody Catholics.
Oh, you can use something on her.
Look at them, bloody Catholics, filling the bloody world up with bloody people they can't afford to bloody feed.
What are we, dear?
Protestant, and fiercely proud of it.
I shouldn't have laughed so badly then. The crunching at the end.
Why do they have so many children?
Because every time they have sexual intercourse, they have to have a baby.
But it's the same with us, Harry. Well, I mean, we've got two children, and we've had sexual intercourse twice.
That's not the point. We could have it any time we wanted.
Really?
Really? What? Okay, I think we're meant to give her something. Really?
Oh yes, and what's more, because we don't believe in all that papist claptrap, we can take precaution.
What do you mean? Lock the door?
Lock the door?
No, no. I mean, because we are members of the Protestant Reformed Church, which successfully challenged the autocratic power of the papacy in the mid-16th century, we can wear little rubber devices to prevent issue.
What do you mean?
I could, if I wanted, have sexual intercourse with you.
Oh, yes, Harry.
And, by wearing a rubber sheath over my old fella, I could ensure that when I came off, you would not be impregnated.
Ooh. Ooh.
Ooh.
That's what being a Protestant's all about. That's why it's the church for me. That's why it's the church for anyone who respects the individual and the individual's right to decide for him or herself. When Martin Luther nailed his protest up to the church door in 1517, he may not have realized the full significance of what he was doing. But 400 years later, thanks to him, my dear, I can wear whatever I want on my John Thomas. And Protestantism doesn't stop at the simple condom. Oh, no.
Oh.
I can wear French ticklers if I want. That's why it's the church for me.
I actually started... I watched about half of the film before doing this video just to remind myself of some of it. And I obviously didn't watch enough because I didn't get to the point where they started having lots of nudity in the film. And there's been lots in this. So I probably should have finished watching it. But yeah, this game is pretty insane. Seems to be following the film. Oh, he's looking at me. Stop looking at me.
You what?
French ticklers, black mambles, crocodile ribs, sheaths that are designed not only to protect, but also to enhance the stimulation of sexual congress.
Have you go on?
And, yeah, I wonder if they're going to have the whole financial institution becoming a pirate ship bit from the beginning of the film.
Have I got one? Well, no. But I can go down the road any time I want and walk into Harry's and hold my head up high and say in a loud, steady voice, Harry, I want you to sell me a condom. In fact, today I think I'll have a French tickler, for I am a Protestant.
Well, why don't you? Well, why don't you?
But they cannot, because their church never made the great leap out of the Middle Ages and the domination of alien episcopal supremacy.
Go down to the House of Fun. And another baby. Crunchy baby. And I think we got as far as we can.
Excuse me.
Oh.
Who taught you your manners? Do not click here. You're being rude.
So I think we got to use something with her to get past this bit, because he's just going to keep eating babies. Ooh.
And will you be having intercourse tonight?
Ooh.
And it just keeps repeating that bit, so I think we have to leave here. So I wonder if we have to get them... Oh, that goes back to the hospital.
He was handsome, all right. But the power and glory and the mystery of the Lord is no substitute for a good cuddle.
I was a carpenter myself. Bloody ironic, if you ask me. A cross is more than just two boards nailed together. It takes time and patience and love.
I can go down the road and walk into Harry's and say, Harry, I want you to sell me a condom.
I believe this game was made in 1997. I was going to go grab the box and show it to the screen, but you can't see it. I've not set up the camera. So yeah, I've actually got it fully boxed, and I've got the manual here. You can obviously hear the manual. And copyright 1997, so it was made quite a few years after the film. So it's quite an old game. And if you want to realise how much older it makes it, it was published by Panasonic.
I can walk into Harry's and say, sell me a condom.
Who can remember when Panasonic used to publish games?
Hi, my name is Leo. I like books and popcorn and I love to water ski.
Yes, my friends, if you're the lucky 10 billionth soul to follow me onto the path of righteousness, you'll receive a brand new snack tech food dehydrator, great for apples, bananas, apricots, beef jerky, and the body of Christ.
I forgot to tell you, once you've had it immaculate, you'll never go back to doing it any other way.
Oh, God.
Immaculate conception, she says, likely bloody story.
Hi, my name's Innocent. Innocent by name, but not by nature. Come and give us a try. You might be surprised. Hi, my name's Innocent. Innocent.
I think that might be everything we can do here.
He was handsome.
So, you can...
Me without your penny.
Oh, there we go. We can spend a penny.
Harry, I want you to sell me a condom. In fact, today I think I'll have a French tickler.
There you go.
Hey, we get...
Oh, a condom! A French tickler!
Now we have the French tickler. We can now give it to them and...
Oh, thank you. Would you care for some cream?
Oh, what? Oh.
Cream!
Okay. Oh, and there we go. So, we had to get cream from birth. Obviously. So, I think it's less of having to get bits to help you in other sections. Everything you need is in that section. Possibly. So, let's go back here. And I have a horrible, horrible feeling we have to go through that quiz again. So it's your big, big chance to make your mother very, very disappointed in you. You decide to join the Communist Party, build weapons for a Middle Eastern dictator, give money to the Church of Scientology, or sleep with a communist member of the Church of Scientology. Yeah, that would probably be the worst thing.
And spotteth twice there the camels before the third hour.
So, I think we went through... Yeah, so there's something I can do with that, but we can't do that yet. We can go back there. So, I think we're going to try and do that terrible quiz again. And we can also give something to this guy as well. See? But we have nothing in our inventory. So.
I'm warning you! I may decide to set an exam this term. Could you kindly wake up? I have no intention of going through this all again.
So. I assume this is what we need to do.
Hello, my name is Kenneth. Hello and welcome to You Don't Know John, the program where modern erudition and historical knowledge clash within a competitive context. Question number one.
Extra valuable bonus question.
The name of this category is extra valuable bonus question. A correct answer will be worth £5.
Mm.
And here is your question. Books are generally considered good, but they can also be quite bad because, one, they could fall off a shelf and hit somebody on the head. Two,
the ink is made of poison.
The answer you've given is stupid and wrong.
Don't.
Question number two.
Lifting very heavy objects and hurting your back.
The name of this category is lifting very heavy objects and hurting your back. A correct answer will be worth £10. And here is your question. If you found the wreck of an old space capsule and inside it were the remains of a freeze-dried Wizzo quality assortment, which of the following could possibly be your favorite flavor? One, spleen bile swirl. Two, crusty pus delight. Three, ram's bladder cup. Four, cold sore taffy.
They all sound pretty bloody terrible. Cold sore taffy?
You must be joking. Question number three.
Fear-inspiring salads of the druids.
The name of this category is Fear-Inspiring Salad Dressings of the Druids. A correct answer will be worth £15. And here is your question. According to Friedrich Engels in the Communist Manifesto, the theory of the communists may be summed up in the single phrase...
Last time we tried this, it was that he told us it was answer five, so...
Sorry, the correct answer is five. None of the above.
I don't think we can...
Question
can we
number four.
Pass this? big, big, big ones. Yes, very nice indeed.
The name of this category is Big, Big, Big Ones. Yes, very nice indeed. A correct answer will be worth £25. And here is your question. In the good old days, plants survived by roaming the earth, shooting each other with bolts of electricity, then ripping each other apart with massive, jagged teeth. Nowadays, plants survive using the relatively boring process known as 1. Walking the streets, 2. Dealing drugs, 3. Liquor store holdups, 4. Photosynthesis.
We actually got this right last time. It's photosynthesis.
Photosynthesis is correct. Although plants actually do all those other things, they don't really need to survive.
Let's think, occasionally...
Question number
five. You can actually get questions you can answer. Toupees that changed the world.
The name of this category is Toupees that changed the world. A correct answer will be worth £50. And here is your question. If you've been playing this game correctly up to this point, the answer to this question will be obvious. 1. Up 3 spaces. 2. Down 2 squares. 3. The second door on the right. 4. The mystery spot.
The mystery spot.
Oh, that's too bad, but please don't be too disappointed. We'll ask you this question again later. Question number 6.
Better get a bucket, I'm going to throw up.
The name of this category is Better get a bucket, I'm going to throw up. A correct answer will be worth £100.
I'm now minus 40.
And here is your question. If you were watching reruns on television and accidentally drank an overdose of clofidianol, which of the following symptoms would you not expect to experience? 1. Blurred vision. 2. Hallucinations. 3. A coma. 4. Andrew Lloyd Webber lying unconscious in a pool of his own saliva.
I don't think that's symptoms to anything, so...
Very good, you weren't fooled. Andrew Lloyd Webber lying unconscious in a pool of his own saliva is not a symptom of an overdose. It is the basis for a lovely Christmas card.
There we go. We now got £60.
Well, now it's time for Final John, the last round of our competition, so I shall explain the rules. If you have too many words...
The category of exotic danger, upside down... Cake for children and warm
the
cuddles,
The category
too.
You have chosen is Cake for the children and warm cuddles, too. So you can be relatively sure that your matches will have nothing to do with that. Every time you are right, you will be awarded money. However, every time you are wrong, money will be taken away. Please remember the words moving from side to side will not be considered a match unless they fit the clue, which descends slowly from the top to the bottom of your screen.
Yes.
Now, assuming these rules are understood, let's begin with Final John.
So I think we need to try and get over £400. To be or... the piston engine, shall I call you Jim Sally? Yabba Dabba Doo, the Treaty of... I can't even pronounce that. Oh, not to be. There we go. 47 mud wrestling dwarfs. 2 to go home. It's a man's life. A bedside bottle of motor oil. Captain and a bedside bottle of... there? Nope. And 7 years ago. Hey! I think all the other bits are... useless compared to this. Father forgive me, for they are full of shit. They are slipping it to my mum behind your back. Promised her a shower, bought gifts, balloons, and a pony for us to ride. They know not what they do. I came, I saw, I misshaved them for fun and profit. Forgot what I came and wandered off again. Yeah, done that one. Made cheese mushroom omelette. Spit on David. Missed this. Conquered. E equals D plus one. Captain Nimlo, the magnificent, wonderful thing. A big ball of rat. Certain doom for all who look upon it. Big Trouble. Let's repeat it again. Mass times the speed of light squared. Fools rush in where the toilet is backed up. A man's life in the bathhouse. Aliens with big sharp teeth. Big Trouble. Angels fear to tread. A rose by anywhere, the smell certain doom. As bad as you, dear, happy anniversary. so sweet that the act of sniffing it would burst your nose apart in an olfactory explosion. As sweet.
Really quite good. Well, that's the end of our competition. I hope you enjoyed it as thoroughly as I did. Well done, player. You've made it into our pantheon of terribly smart people. In recognition of this very important achievement, we present you with this.
Ooh, a bottle of linseed oil!
Hey, we got a bottle of linseed oil.
Remember, you may come back and play again if you wish.
See if no, thank you,
you beat your own score, if that is humanly possible. And again, remember, regardless of how much knowledge you've accumulated over the years and how much school you've attended or whether or not you have an advanced degree or you're exhaustively well-read in one subject or a number of subjects, the point to always keep in mind is that you don't know John.
We don't know John, do we? So, oh, here we go. David has threatened to slap you silly, strip you naked, and give you a big loud spanking in front of all your friends unless you tell him the most important part of a well-rounded person, most important part of any well-rounded personality. David is pretty tough, but he's not too bright. So you quickly make up a lie and tell him that it's really important, what's really important is being an upstanding citizen, maintaining good personal hygiene, always being honest, or working diligently. Well, the fact that we're lying to him, I think the only answer has to be is being honest. So now we've got an item, and what's he might be able to use it.
Watson? Do pay attention!
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir.
Ooh, an empty bottle!
He oiled a bird. There is probably something in that somewhere. I don't want to even begin to guess what it might be. But we've got an empty bottle. You're the substitute scoutmaster for Troop Happy. Three cheers for Troop Happy, as they have earned their Wilderness Survival Merit Badges. Good for them. It's now time for their reward. Ah, you've got it. You pile them into your van and drive them to a camp out at Sexy Mama's House of Love, Friendly Eddie's Naked Hug Retreat, Las Vegas, or Disney World. Yep, fill it from the font. That's what I'm going to be doing. I got to take the troop to Sexy House of Love. So, over here. Look at them pissing in the bottle.
Oh, water!
And the water was the thing that we needed to get there. So, hey, hey. We are actually...
I should have been a watch. Probably not much demand for a four-handed watch, though. Well, not unless you like to keep track of different time zones. Oh, come to think of it, that's a great idea. And I could give the date. Beep on the hour. Even glow in the dark. Instead of that, I'm doing this. Oh, come on, be strong, Walter. Remember the wife and kids.
While we're here, let's save. Because... yes, I'm perfectly sure. As we're actually making some progress, we've got three items. So let's go back to fighting each other. Oh. So, over there was something we had to give him to make him get lightning bolted. So we can look at that. There's nothing else. Ah! If you wait too long, it just vanishes. Let's go back.
We got something else for you as well, sir.
Oh.
Sorry, it's another clock, sir. I mean, there was a bit of a mix-up.
Well, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. I think we'd better get the cover now, oh, sir, and I'll thank you probably later on.
Corporal Sturridge got this for you as well, sir. He didn't know about the others, sir. It's Swiss.
Well, now that is thoughtful, Sturridge. Good man.
And there's a card, sir. Yep. From all of us.
It's got to be a card.
Blood, sir.
Thank you all.
I am crossing my fingers that the terrible encoding, or the old-fashioned... That the old-fashioned encoding and stuff will mean that it doesn't get picked up by the copyright protection.
Three cheers for Captain Biggs! Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
I'll be alright, sir. Oh, there's just one other thing, sir. Spadge, give him the check.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man, this is really going too far.
I'll be able to find you, sir. Bin number 4, Trent.
For Christ's sake, forget it, man.
You shouldn't have said that, sir. You've hurt his feelings now.
Let's not give him the cake.
I don't want any cake.
Look, Blackett cooked especially for you, you bastard.
Yeah, he saved his rations for 6 weeks, sir.
Sorry, I don't mean to be ungrateful. Yeah. I'll be all right.
So we're just to keep just clicking on this and going through each of these sections.
He worked on
of
that cake
sketch.
Like no one else I've ever known. Some nights it was so cold we could hardly move. But Blackie'd be out there slicing the lemons, mixing the sugar and the almonds. I mean, you tried trying to get butter to melt at 15 degrees below zero. There's love in that cake. This man's love. And this man's care. And this... Oh my Christ. bastard.
You bastard.
All right. We will eat the cake. They're right, it's too good a cake not to eat. Get the plates and knives, Walters.
Yes, sir. How many plates?
6. No, better make it 5.
Tablecloth, sir?
Yes, get the tablecloth. No. I'll get the tablecloth. And better get the Gaelic table hot.
And the little mat, sir?
Yes. Oh, and while you're at it, better get a doily.
I'll bring Sousa in case you want
to scrumple.
Okay.
Oh, there's more of it.
Sir, if we don't meet again, sir, I'd just like to say it's been a real privilege fighting alongside you, sir.
Yes, well,
that just loops back round again.
May God strike me down were it to be otherwise.
Right, so I was hoping that we'd keep going through that and it would actually give us something, but no. It just keeps going.
Oh, that's much better. Thank you, honey. You
clean that lens. I wonder if it is just the shooting gallery. You have to keep going. One of those games you don't know if you're actually making progress or not, or if you just sort of found some weird funny thing that they put in just for shits and giggles. Question is, how long do you keep going? Thank you. Okay. I don't think this is more than just silliness. And that just takes us back to this again. Oh, this is slightly different. Donate your organs, they're for good of the country. I wonder if we've got the organ donor bit. Okay, maybe there was more we could do with the Zulu bits. Yeah. This game is the ultimate troll, really, isn't it? That you can't tell if you're being trolled or not. God.
Sorry about the mess.
Ashes to ashes.
Gosh. I don't think I've ever had a game quite troll me as badly as this. I think that takes you... That takes you back to the battlefield? I'm just going to mostly skip over these things because I don't think they're actually useful in any way whatsoever. Ah, we can go into the jungle. Yes. That's what we want, isn't it? To go into the jungle. Your sister Betty has got a terrible mysterious rash. You strike it with a switch of raspberry bramble, but it does no good. Based on your own feelings about standard modern medicine practices versus the power of the mind to heal the body, you decide to soak her with a garden hose.
It's huge!
Look at that. Look at the lion. It's massive.
Don't shoot. We're not a tiger.
Why are you dressed as a tiger?
We are dressed as a tiger because he had an auntie who did it in 1839, and this is the 50th anniversary. We're dressed like this because... Oh, no, that's not it. We found the tiger skin in a bicycle shop in Cairo. The owner wanted it taken down to Dar es Salaam. Well, actually, we're on a mission for British intelligence. There's a pro-Tsarist Ashanti chief...
No.
Oh, why? Oh, it's a lovely day today.
I swear this game is even more sort of mental than the film.
No, we're doing it for a bet.
Oh, you actually get stuck in
here. Oh, we did it for a lark, part of a spree. High spirits, you know, simple as that. Nothing more to it.
Can you imagine the poor artist who had to sit and sort of try and cut out all this from the film stock? That must have taken ages.
To tell the truth, we are completely mad. We're inmates of a Bengali psychiatric institution, and we escaped by making this skin out of old used cereal packets.
Mm. No, we're doing it for an advertisement.
Ah, that's it. Forget about the Russians. We're doing an advert for Tiger Brand Coffee.
Tiger Brand Coffee is a real treat. Even tigers prefer a cup of it to real meat. It's because we were thinking of training as taxidermists and we want to get the feel of it from the animal's point of view. God told us to do it.
Doesn't matter why they're dressed as a tiger, have they got my leg?
Good thinking. Well, have you? Oh, come on. I mean, do we look like the sort of chaps who'd creep into a camp at night, steal into someone's tent, anaesthetise them, tissue tight them, amputate a leg and run away with it?
Yes.
Search the thicket.
Well, he was a politician.
So he didn't really need it, you see?
No use for it at all. I wouldn't know what it was if it hit him. Well, he was a politician.
Yep. So he didn't... there was a big bloody foot sale at Harrods. And I bought three. Two. This is the one I bought.
This is actually one of two Python games. There was actually a Monty Python game on the Amiga, which was not directly based on any of the films or the TV. Well, it was based on the TV series, in a way. And it was sort of a collection of mini games and was pretty mental. I'm sure if you look around, you can find it. But obviously, don't look now, because you should be watching me trying to work out what the hell I'm doing in this game.
There was a big bloody foot sale at Harrods.
Oh, can I click on that?
A wooden leg? No, a proper leg. Look, he was fast asleep and someone or something came in and removed it.
The ship one. There might have been more. I definitely remember there was the Amiga one. But it's quite possible there's more. Oh, there's definitely going to be long plays of all of them. I'm sure there's some long plays of this one. Oh, Starship Titanic was... Yeah. If you've not checked out the Civ 11 review, or... these reviews... He sort of just does mental videos, but Civ 11 did a great one on Starship Titanic.
Simple as that. Oh, why? 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 Oh, isn't it a lovely day today? Oh, leg! You're looking for a leg!
A leg!
Actually, I think there is one in there somewhere. Somebody must have abandoned it. Somebody must have abandoned it here, knowing you were coming after it. And we stumbled across it, actually, and wondered what it was. And they'll be miles away by now, and I expect we'll have to take all of the blame.
As usual.
There was a big bloody foot sale at Harrods. And I...
There's no more with them. Oh, we can actually look around again now. I thought we were still stuck. Oh, that was the brain.
I'm taking a native art sculpture class in the local village.
Yes, he did.
That's a spare. We got it because there was a special at the hospital in Marrakesh.
I am the Grim Reaper.
Well, he's not supposed to be in there.
Now, that is not the hand of God.
Definitely not.
Maybe the hand of Moses.
Or Ezekiel.
Or one of the lesser prophets. Like the one who stuttered.
Definitely not the hand of God, and it doesn't have any special powers. None whatsoever.
None whatsoever. It's surprisingly non-powerful for the hand of God.
Which it isn't. It's not the hand of God.
It totally is the hand of God, and hopefully... Yeah, we can pick up the hand of God.
Hey, the hand of God! Wow!
So now we can go and we can now strike the guy down with the hand of God lightning. Yep. We're slowly making progress with this. the whole thing with the questions. There we go.
That is why we'll always need an army. And may God strike me down were it to be otherwise.
That... I feel like...
Ooh, nice leg.
I feel I used the phrase, I wasn't expecting that quite a bit with this game, but I truly don't expect half of what this game does. I think I'm playing someone's fever dream. So I'm going to guess we're going to have to give the leg to these guys. Actually, no, we don't do it here, do we?
Right, search the thicket.
I'm going to go back. So I think, if I remember rightly from what was, 2 hours ago, we go into the tent.
Excuse me, sir. I'm afraid Perkins got rather badly bitten during the night.
Can we? Yeah, there we go. And we can give him the leg.
Oh, thanks, Doc.
Not at all. That's what I'm here for. Hello? And now your prize. I can salmon.
And yes, we've now got the canned salmon. Oh, so now it's like, what? Oh, live organ transplant. Oh, dear. Oh, dear, oh, dear.
The only thing I ask is that you don't throw any darts. The last person threw darts. I didn't much like that.
The Meaning of Life, Part 5. Live Organ Transplants.
Don't play it there! I'll get it!
I'll get it.
Yes? Hello, can we have your liver?
Oh God, the eyebrows. So yeah, I should have expected... Ah!
Well, welcome, contestants! Gather up the kids, pull out your mum and the family pooch and get ready, because once again it's time to play Doctor, as you begin...
Live Organ Transplants!
Yes, sirree! I see you're ready to go, so let's get right to it! Tonight's patient is a friendly fellow with an organ donor's card in his wallet. So let's have a big round of applause, please, for Mr. Edgar Free Samples!
Right. I'm using it!
I'm using it!
Isn't he just a kick in the balls? The game clock starts as soon as you pick a surgical instrument from the selection Janice has so helpfully laid out for you. For your incision, make sure you follow the dotted line on Mr. Free Sample's super duper solar plexus. See if you can get inside before time runs out. Good luck, contestant, and happy
I cutting. Get the feeling this is going to get bloody. Yep.
Crikey! What a mess! And what a corpse! Uh-oh, I don't see any organs. That's a darn shame, contestant, but if you want to try again, just pick up a tool and the clock will start all over. Well, hell, looks to me like we got a live one. Okay. Once again, it's time for...
Live
organ transplants. And we're doing it.
Oh, very nice.
Yes.
Or it would be if you were performing an appendectomy. Well, am I right?
Right!
Sorry to say, the appendix is not the organ we're after. Looks like you'll have to try again.
Right here. Oh, going round a corner. Round another corner. Oh, no, I don't. Where is this going?
Wowie, wowie, wow. Now that is one great gash. Unfortunately, the man we pay £4 to draw the lines on the patient has got it wrong again. You'll have to make another cut, dearie.
Yeah, this game is very, very weird. But I wouldn't expect anything less from a Monty Python game that supposedly some of the pythons actually were involved in. Oh. Oh god. And keep circling round and around. Doesn't seem like the best incision.
Just look at that slit! Such form, such skill! Clearly, the incision wasn't challenging enough for you, was it? Here, try this one.
Oh, Doctor. Lord. What now? Am I drawing dick butts? This might predate dick butt, but I feel I'm drawing dick butt. Oh, I'm drawing a penguin. Oh no.
Down the belly. You make it look as easy as cutting up a kidney pie. Get it? Kidney pie?
Oh, ho, ho.
Now here's one that'll start you sweating.
Oh no, not more. I really hope that if I make a mistake, I don't have to start again. Oh.
Whoops! There goes your bright future at the abattoir. That's a darn shame, contestant, but if you want to try again, just pick up a tool and the clock will start all over. I know you can do it, contestant.
Okay. So, at least don't have to start again from the beginning. The designers weren't completely evil. Just mostly. Right, come on. We can do this. We can do this. So I'm not, like, you have to sort of slightly
Ouch!
Guess.
I'm afraid he's dead now.
Where to click. It's sort of just easier to hold the mouse button down and just move it slightly. No! And the blood covers up the...
That
I swear I was doing that right.
Oh, wow.
I swear I somehow did that when I wasn't holding the button, so I don't know if you need me to hold the button.
Ouch! I'm afraid he's dead now. That's the spirit.
Well, you do need to hold it. That's...
Crikey! That's the ticket!
This
never say die!
Oh! Thank
well.
For that.
Oh dear. Well, I don't think any of us were expecting this. Not exactly. So, yes. I see by the clock on the wall that we're out of time. So, that's it. Thanks very much on behalf of Jennison and myself. So long, safe driving, and thanks for playing...
Live organ
transport. That broke my brain. Okay, we need something to connect to there. So we got a fridge. What the? Oh no, we're not going back to that again. Not this soon.
You do realise he has to be, dead, by the terms of the card, before he donates his liver.
Well, I told him that, but he never listens to me. Silly man. Typical of him. He goes down to the public library, sees a few signs up, comes home all full of good intentions.
Yeah. The game definitely has the universe song. They actually use it when you quit. So I don't know if we're going to get it in part of this, but we might do.
Yes, I'm in here, waiting ever so patiently to be released.
You're not doctors, then?
Oh, blimey, no.
Has anyone seen my hat? I am the pancreas, the queen of tummy meats.
I am the spleen. I filter blood, and I can sing in two octaves.
Yes.
Spleen! Spleen!
Spoon!
Yeah, finally beat it. That was painful. I think that drove a lot of people away from the stream. I don't blame them. That was terrible.
I'm a bladder. Try me. I'm really quite tasty.
Oi, look at me. I'm kosher. Well, not exactly kosher. Maybe mostly kosher, except for the rat meat. Well, and the droppings swept up off the slaughterhouse floor. Oh, yes, and the pig. But other than that, I'm strictly kosher.
I smell something. What is it? Ethiopian? Canadian? Ah, stockbroker.
Oh, thanks! I couldn't get that!
Okay, that was good.
Hi, I'm a piece of cheese. I'm not an organ, but if you hold me in your hands and make me warm, you can squish me into the shape of a kidney. Voila! An instant cheesy kidney treat for the kids' lunch at school. What better way to say, I love you?
What better way?
No, it's not.
I love it here, darling.
Me too, Marvin.
Obviously.
You're not Dr. Zen.
Oh, blimey, no.
Annie, I was wondering, well, you know, what you was thinking of doing after that. I mean, would you stay on your own? Or is there, someone else sort of on the horizon?
Well, I'm certainly not thinking of getting hitched up again.
Sure.
Sure.
Can we have your liver then?
Oh, no, I'd be scared.
All right. I'll tell you what. Look, listen to this.
Whenever life gets you down, Mrs. Brown, and things seem hard or tough, and people are stupid, obnoxious, or daft, and you feel that you've had quite enough. Just remember that you're standing on a planet that's evolving and revolving at 900 miles an hour. That's orbiting at 19 miles a second, so it's reckoned a sun that is the source of all our power. The sun and you and me and all the stars that we can see are moving at a million miles a day. In an outer spiral arm at 40,000 miles an hour of the galaxy we call the Milky Way.
Sing along if you know the song.
Our galaxy itself contains 100 billion stars. It's 100,000 light years side to side. It bulges in the middle, 16,000 light years thick, but out by us it's just 3,000 light years wide. We're 30,000 light years from galactic central point. We go round every 200 million years. And our galaxy is only one of millions of billions in this amazing and expanding universe.
Universe. I think we're going to get more reasons why this is set to mature audiences only.
The universe itself keeps on expanding and expanding in all of the directions it can whiz. As fast as it can go, at the speed of light, you know, 12 million miles a minute, and that's the fastest speed there is. So remember when you're feeling very small and insecure, how amazingly unlikely is your birth. and pray that there's intelligent life somewhere up in space, cause there's bugger all down here on Earth.
Never a truer word has been sung.
Sort of insignificant, doesn't it?
Yeah. Can we have your liver then?
All right, you talk me into it.
Ooh.
Yoink.
Ooh, a liver.
So I think we can plug this liver back into the dude. Oh. There we go.
Oh, a vacuum cleaner.
I'm guessing you have to... What do we need a vacuum cleaner for? To suck. Oh, spam! That's it. There we go. It's got to be the spam. Nope. It's got an engine. And
an onion.
Because that was obviously what we needed to collect. An onion. So what we got next?
The Meaning of Life, Part 6, The Autumn Years.
Ah, good afternoon, sir, and how are we today?
Oh, dear.
Better get a bucket, I'm gonna throw up.
Ah, Gaston? A bucket for monsieur.
Well, save. Are we?
Merci, Gaston.
I haven't finished.
Oh, pardon, Gaston. 1,000 pardons, monsieur. Now, this afternoon, we have monsieur's favorite, the jugged hare. The hare is very high, and the sauce is very rich, with truffles, anchovies, Grand Marnier, bacon, and cream. Thank you, Gaston.
There's still more.
Allow me. A new bucket for monsieur. And the cleaning woman. Et maintenant, would monsieur care for an apéritif, or would he prefer to order straight away? Today, we have for appetizers, excuse me, moule marinière, pâté de foie gras, beluga caviar, eggs benedictine, tarte de poireau, that's leek tarte, frog's legs, amandine, or Oeftekai Richard Shepherd, c'est-à-dire little quail's eggs and a bed of pureed mushroom. It's very delicate, very subtle.
I'll have the lot.
Saving, yes, I'm gonna second save because I believe there is meant to be some terrible bug with the game that it's possible to break it. Hopefully we've not got to, this might be this point, I don't know. So, yes, saving and then preparing for this bit.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Here's a little number I tossed up recently in the Caribbean.
Thank you.
No complaints.
It's just that we have to go. I'm having rather a heavy period.
And we have a train to catch.
I'll have the lot.
Oh, have we actually got a proper puzzle here?
Is there something wrong with the food?
You have to alternate from side to side.
Two green olives stuffed with red pimento, then spectacularly arranged on either side of a single black olive, so as to form a line of three olives varying in color. Sweet and sour fillet.
A wise choice, monsieur.
Minced four.
This puzzle's gonna go on for ages, isn't it?
I hope monsieur was not over.
Supreme.
I think we're guessing there. I thought I was understanding this. I swear, it's just, you gotta take one from each side.
A tasty brick. Sparrow gullet.
you're not happy with the service?
Okay, so it seems different things are different weights. And I didn't quite realise that.
Crispy broiled lamb appendix.
So triangle, triangle. Triangle, triangle, keep it balanced. Triangle.
Crisp. A tasty bread.
Center, square, too heavy, so it must be triangle, square, 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 triangle, that should bring it over. Triangle. Triangle. Ah, I so thought I had it. Link. It's only that one I can select. Not giving commentary, and I keep failing this. This can't be great viewing. So, triangle.
Soup.
Ah, can we keep picking from the same side? That should set me back over there. Back. And we're balanced out again. Can't select circle because that'll overbalance it. So that, that's circle. That. Yes. That again. Oh no, I think I screwed up.
Super. Is there something wrong with the food?
So close! So each icon is worth a different amount.
Sweet and sour fillet of monarch butterfly.
And if it goes too far either direction, it topples over. So that moves it one. These move it two, or is it three? I think that might be three. That brings us back into balance. Those are the bad ones. So I think we can go... that. That should send us over there. Can now do that. Go to do that. That should balance us out again. Can do triangle and circle. Triangle. Square. Bounces out. Back over there. Square. Send us in the opposite. Ah!
The claws! Frogs!
Let's do That's... let me start. There we go. That. Oh. Try and... What?
A cushion!
I swear, I feel I've got it, and then I do something that seems to screw it all up. I'll send it back over there. That should... back there. Center us. That should... this way. Center us. That way. This is getting late now. My brain, I think, starting to shut down. We want that. Over that way. Center us again. It's too much. That. 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 Center us.
Crispy.
Damn you, minigame puzzles! Particularly when you just about think you've got it. That centers us, so we should be able to...
Two green olives?
Shush you. That... centers us. Square is okay. That should take us all the way back over there. This should center us. Oh, no, because it's three. That centers us. That would be...
there's a clause!
Okay. Yes. That. That. Try and center us out again. Back that way. Back that way. Circle is a three. So we do that. Circle should bring us over there. That's a two.
Sweet. Sweeten.
Oh. Ooh. Yeah!
Pardon me, monsieur. A whiff of thin mint.
I'll commit another thing. I'm absolutely...
It's only a whiff of thin.
It's only a...
fuck off, I'm full.
It's only a whiff of thin mint. Whiff of thin. And get ready for the scene that Quentin Tarantino described as the most traumatic thing ever put to film, and the only thing that has ever disturbed him. Thin mint.
Oh,
Oh, lovely.
Ooh, gelatine.
And so, let's see if we can. Does this finish the game, or is there another part to this? I bet there's another part to this. Let's see if we can finish Death, which at that point is probably going to be about 3 hours long, and it'll probably be save. Keep saving before we go into any section. Actually, I think my throat's about to go. I think I might call this a night, to be honest, and we'll do a part two later, because my throat is feeling pretty bad, and seeing that I've had a horrible chesty cold and my throat's been pretty terrible, I think it's probably a good idea to leave it for the night. But I think we did quite well, and thank you so very much for watching. And we will definitely be doing this again, because this is pure insanity. Just look at this guy.
Time for tea yet? Oh, blimey, my arms are killing me.
So, yeah, I will be back again to finish this off, because who wants to start a game and not finish it? And it has been a lot of fun, and it's been pretty, pretty insane. And fingers crossed, YouTube isn't going to copyright strike me or anything like that. So the replays will actually stay up for people to watch. And so, is that the button? No, it's up. So, when we quit, we get...
Just remember that you're standing on a planet that's evolving and revolving at 900 miles an hour.
We get the song again.
That's orbiting at 90 miles a second, so it's reckoned a sun that is the source of all our power.
Doo-doo-doo.
The sun and you and me and all the stars that we can see are moving at a million miles a day.
So remember, everyone, that if you enjoyed this video, then you should like and subscribe. I am not going to attempt to sing anymore, because I think I'll drive people away.
Contains 100 billion stars. It's 100,000 light years side to side.
I will leave you.
It bulges in the middle, 16,000 light years thick. But out by us, it's just 3,000 light years wide.
Song.
We're 30,000 light years from galactic.
I wouldn't call it
nice. We go round every 200 million years. And our galaxy is only one of millions of billions in this amazing and expanding universe.
Universe. I'm not even sure how long this credit sequence is.
The universe itself keeps on expanding and expanding in all of the directions it can whiz.
It might be the entire song.
As fast as it can go, at the speed of light, you know. 12 million miles a minute, and that's the fastest speed there is. So remember, when you're feeling very small and insecure, how amazingly unlikely is your birth. And pray that there's intelligent life somewhere up in space, cause there's bugger all down here on Earth.
Thank you, and see you next time.